إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير ليس لنا رب سواه ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين يقول المولى عز وجل في كتاب العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد my dear brothers and sisters in Islam إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار نعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من النار My dear brothers and sisters in Islam تفرقت الأسر فكيف تجتمع الأمم The family being divided What do you think about the nations? The family, when we talk about our own Muslim brothers and sisters. The family being divided, a problem between the spouse and the child. So what do you think about the nation, the Muslim nation, the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing us as He was testing all the prophets. He gave them a test after the other, and he wanna see the response of those prophets. And they respond from all of them, they depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But they keep asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something. As Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide him, but he depend on Allah all the time. إِنِّي زَاهِبٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ I'm going wherever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide me. So he left himself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even while he was going to use his son by the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put the knife in him. He listened to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nuh alayhi salam is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about his son. Oh Allah, he's from my son. He said, oh Nuh, he's not from you. He's listening to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Isa alayhi salam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him by the food and that, and the people ask him, oh Isa, ask your God to bring a food for us. Allah bring a whole surah, surah al-Ma'idah, how the food came to Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. Musa alayhi salam, when he was going to cross the water, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, just put your stick, you will be a solid, and you cross in you and your people. It's testing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For our time in the dunya, we're not familiar with any of that. We just heard the story from the Quran and from the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But every single one of us, if we go back months ago, in the month of Rajab, we raise our hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, give us barakah in the month of Rajab and Sha'ban, وَبَلِّغْنَا Ramadan, and let all of us be in the month of Ramadan together. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for everyone of you in this room today, or downstairs, or who is alive until now from the Muslim people, Allah accepted their du'a. So they attended the month of Ramadan. During the month of Ramadan, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and يُبَلِّغْنَا لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ We all raise our hand, and this night you see whole masajid backed up. They cannot even take the more people inside the masajid. They close the doors for the numbers of the people. We see that in the night of Laylatul Qadr, they're assuming the 27 or the 29. Same thing as the Eid time. You see the crowd and how the people is fighting to find a place to pray. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us this year to all, most of us to pray in the park. It's ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our du'a, we have to continue the same way. We have to put ourselves in a situation, how is my Ramadan? And how is the month of Shawwal? Isn't it Shawwal month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? As the month of Ramadan is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave His 12 months, not the human beings. So we have to understand every month is by the power and the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Month of Shawwal, which we all in it right now, if you fast the 6th of Shawwal, as you forgive the whole dahr, the whole year. Alhamdulillah, but if you cannot, you cannot. It's a sunnah. But they call it the month of Shawwal because they said this is the month the Ebel get engaged together, the camel get engaged together, they can get pregnant in this month. That's a jahili time. But Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he corrected all of that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But this is the time Aisha radiallahu anha wa ardaha, the mother of the believers, she was talking to the wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he married me in the month of Shawwal. She's proud. By the month she got married from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So you are in the month, your mother Aisha, she was proud that she got married in this month. And this month has the battle of Uhud and the battle of Hanin. And this is another example from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to see how in the beginning the Muslim, they lose the war and they get it back again in the Hanin time. Why? As we are said it today, how many Muslims in the earth today? Plenty. And this is the warning from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said we'll be affected. Did Ya Rasulullah, when? When we have plenty of Muslims in the earth. Ya Rasulullah, when we are a lot? Yes. And this is the fitna. That's what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned before he died sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In Hanin time, the battle of Hanin, they are assuming there are a huge number, 12,000 Muslims, they're gonna go and fight. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, we go out of Mecca and we meet them by the border, so we don't have a war in and out. 12,000 is a lot at this time. Even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from the number of the people, he starts to rent the weapons from the disbelievers. And he said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, because you enter Mecca now and you have all those troops, are you taking the weapons from us by the power? He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I'm renting it. I'm not taking anything by the power. See how is the mercy and the love of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for the others too, for the disbelievers. Because of this number, the believers, as we are today, we are Muslim, alhamdulillah. So what we are doing by our Islam? Nothing. We are Muslim, we pray, obey zakah, sadaqah, but we not practice real will, no actions. So the numbers would get in huge, they're assuming they're going to win the war no matter what. So in the beginning, they lost, they ran away. This is only few of the Sahaba who surrounded Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the rest is run, they run. But you have one lady, Ummu Salim, the wife of Talha radiallahu anhuma. She was carrying a hanger, a small knife in her hand, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what is it? She said, Ya Rasulullah, anyone come to me, I'm just putting it in him. He was laughing, imagine. But her husband Talha, he has a strong voice. And the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, call the people to stop, to stand back again. We cannot lose this war. And he listened to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they came back again by the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they win the battle. We say that because when we get more, we got lazy. Exam, when you're a child, or we went through any exam, you know the father sometime when the kids came from the school after the exam, how is the exam today? It's okay. What you mean it's okay? Now, who defend him right away? We all face that, the mother. What she said, leave him alone, enough, he studied the whole year. Whatever comes, it's from Allah. But when the result came back, he passed the exam. I told you my son is good. But if fail, you're going to see the hand of the father, right? Told you, not listening, and that we divide the family. But this is the exam in the dunya among the human being together. But what is about the exam in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When you meet him subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's two places. But one call from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a very strong call to the hellfire. When he called her to come, the hellfire will come in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, limited. And the Jannah is opened. Today, if we think about how the hellfire will be and how the heaven is, I need you to remember that by the mask you put in your mouth. See, so many people now get into different colors, matching with the clothes, sister matching with the hijab, and all of this beautiful thing. Remember, when you put that, there is a Jannah and the hellfire, wal'iyadhu billah. Different living, different colors. The hellfire on the top of each other levels, and all different color depend on the heat. If you have a flame in your home, and you still, if in 60 degrees, different than 100 degrees, you can see the difference, the color. And the Jannah has a lot of fruits, different color, beautiful. It's all great, which grade you at? The first, or the second, or the third, with the prophet, with no prophet, you are the last person in the Jannah, or the front line. It is all different. So when you put this one, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put you in the highest grade of the Jannah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all of us to be there, inshallah. So my dear brothers and sisters, when we finish the month of Ramadan, we're all so generous. Generous not only for the other, for our own bodies. You're standing for your prayer, you practice, you go up and down. Physical therapy, natural physical therapy. You don't need a therapist, but your own, because you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I know sometimes they rush the imam when he lead in the tarawih. He took too long in your ruku', he took too long in your sujood. Today in Germany, they treat the people from the headache by the sujood position. They treat the people over there in Germany, the scientists, by fasting. Isn't it ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? But you did. So you benefit your own body, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala care about you more than you care about yourself. So in the end, there is two groups. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, come. You are among the people of the Jannah or the hellfire, wal'iyadhu billah. And the malaika is waiting. People who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala threw them in the hellfire, as the kafir, wal'iyadhu billah. Allah will call the hellfire, hal imtala'ti? Are you full? The response, oh Allah, hal min mazid? I need more. But they heard the voice of the hellfire, wal'iyadhu billah. Takadu tamayyazu min al-ghayz. Kullama ulqiya fiha fawjun sa'alahum khazanatuha alam ya'tikum. You don't get any response. You don't get any prophets. You don't get any alerts. Oh, they said, oh, we get it. But we don't think about it at this time. But they're gonna hear the screaming of the hellfire. She did more and more and more and more. But by the door of the hellfire, wal'iyadhu billah, there is a group. Allah mentioned the Holy Quran, so it's Zumur. Zumurah, group together, and Zumurah for the Jannah. These two different groups. And the angels, they always ask the people, أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ رُسُلٌ مِّنْكُمْ يَتْلُونَ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِ رَبِّكُمْ أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ رُسُلٌ مِّنْ عِنْدُكُمْ يَتْلُونَ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِ رَبِّكُمْ وَيُنْذِرُونَكُمْ لِقَاءَ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا قَالُوا بَلَى وَلَكِنْ حَقَّتْ كَلِمَةُ الْعَذَابِ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ. Yes, we got the prophets after prophets, and people alert us, but we didn't listen to that. But look at the other side. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا. The door will open for them. وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ طُبْتُمْ فَادْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ. Welcome. We are waiting for you. We cannot even wait until to see the beautiful faces, the people who pray, who obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the month of Ramadan is guiding us to a beautiful place for the Muslim who say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, filters from the znub and ma'asi to enter the Jannah. We need to continue the track the same way. We need to continue ourselves, because the month of Shawwal is guiding us for manasik al-hajj. So the hajj, if Allah open it for us, you never know. As we pray in the bark, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let the Mecca open for us again, and we pray over there. And we do our hajj, say ameen. May Allah make it easy for all of us again. We all miss Mecca and Medina. We all missed it. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه وارضاه he say يشد الرحال إلى ثلاث take yourself with your equipment with your money with everything to three مساجد الحرم and مسجد رسول الله and بيت المقدس which we all silent when we see what's going on in Al-Quds over there the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us leaders they care about their chair they don't care about the ummah they don't care about the Islam they listen to the leaders of the highest level America, Russia, British but they don't listen to the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala they don't care about the place where the prophets went there Isn't it Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He's given us Surah Isra سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله Isn't it message from the Quran? Let they do whatever For us, we have nothing to do more than the dua Only the dua Because we have no weapons Look The time of the corona The whole world is shut off By something no one can see it The virus You cannot see it by your own eyes. No way, it's impossible. And the whole world is shut off. When everything is starting getting a little better, the war starts again among the human being. I'm not talking between Israel and Palestine. Talk about the whole world. How many people in our Muslim country inside the jails? Boys, young girls, teenagers, older, they die inside the jail, inside our Muslim countries. When the virus shut off the whole world, these people, they're not listening that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing us every single day. Preparing ourselves in the month of Shawwal because we start to enter Manasik al-Hajj, the time for the Hajj. So you're moving from Ramadan to al-Hajj. We're not saying what's after Ramadan. Because this is weird. Everybody say, oh, the shuk now talk about what's after Ramadan, what's after Ramadan. What's after Ramadan is coming the Hajj. It's a reminder from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Take it this way, ya Sheikh. Move from one month to another until you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we said in the dua, oh Allah, take us, take Ramadan from us and return it back to us. You ask Him to extend your life in the dunya, to attend another Ramadan. So the Hajj is coming. Move forward for that. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make Mecca close and may Allah make it open, inshallah, and you have the money for the Hajj, make the niyyah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and give this money for the poor and need, Allah will count it for you. But we have yaqeen from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will open again. And we're going to pray again over there. As we see now in Saudi Arabia, they did a great, great job. They vaccinated everyone. So they, as a good step. And they start, since they opened the door, 1,000 of Saudi people start traveling to different places. So it's a good sign, alhamdulillah. But when we say that, still we have to take our questions. Brothers and sisters, when they said, you are in an area, all vaccinated, take the mask off, don't listen to that now. Wait. My personal advice, nothing else. So many brothers in the masajid who I know, they vaccinated and they get it for the third time. For the third time. They always pray with us, they are home isolated. Some of them in the ICU. I'm talking about brothers who I know. They get it for the third time. So please continue the way you act, even they said take it off. Inside your home, it's up to you. With your family. Because if you're one infected, everyone will get infected. So this is message from the human beings. Imagine the message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, I give the life and this. تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير. الذي خلق الموت والحياة. He's the one who created the life and death. And He's asking you to fast, to give sadaqah, to give zakah, and we listen to Allah, we listen to the shaitan. Do you know the shaitan, when he give advice, he say, I don't give it to you. I'm a kafir. Don't follow me. Look what he did to Mulk Sulaiman. They said to Mulk Sulaiman, and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the angels is a hasad And they divide the family, but they cannot do it without the permission of Allah. But what they say? حَتَّى يَقُولَ إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ فِتْنَةٌ فَلَا تَكْفُرْ. They asking you, don't be among the kafir. They did the kufr, but they not asking you to follow them. They said, don't do it. Don't do it. But why they behind you if they ask you not to? Because they promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will behind you everywhere they go. And the response from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَإِنِّي أَنَا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. I am the one who forgive. So the shaitan, even when he gave that, he don't want you to be in among the kafir. But he promised Allah, he want to do his job the right way. So he's behind you and me and everyone. So we don't need to follow the shaitan. Shaitan started again, my brothers and sisters, from our inside houses. From our houses. The shaitan is there because we never enter our houses, Bismillah. And we leave our houses without Bismillah. We eat without Bismillah. We drink without Bismillah. We go to the shower without Bismillah. We wear our closet without Bismillah. So let Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim front of you all the time. Make tawakkul ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before you leave the house, after you return, every time, smile in your home. Look at your wife, smile in her face. She has to smile in your face too. Everyone tired, everyone facing a lot of issues. Life is not easy like before when the grandparents, they wake up in the Fajr time, they go to the farm, they do their work, they have a nap in the middle, the food is there with the wife, and after that they return to the Maghrib time, they break the Maghrib, wait until the Isha, they get shower, actually they wash the leg by the wife, and then they sleep. That's how their routine is. Not only that, they care about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala duty. When they get the product from the farm, before they give it to anyone else, they say, this is for the guy who cut my hair, this is for the poor and need, this is for the imam of the masjid, because no money at this time. And I think many brothers faced that and saw that too in our age. Today I'm 64, I saw that by my own eyes. I see, when my grandfather, he has the mikyal, the kilo, and he put the weed there, and he said, this is for the imam of the masjid, this is for the one who cut my hair, this is for the poor, this is for my neighbor, and the rest they say for me to sell it or to use it. See how is it? Allah make barakah at this time in their life. We never heard about cancer, we never heard about liver disease, we never heard about anything, but today we have all the diseases. Why? Because we not fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't give the right amount of zakat that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked us to do it. We ignore deenullah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has punished us by that. You see a virus every single day. Disease, you never heard about it before. Because we don't follow our religion. Protect yourself by the sadaqat. Sadaqat is money, prayer extra, dua. Everything is a sadaqah. Even izalat al-adha an al-tariq sadaqah. You move some stone in your way home from some front of someone, it's a sadaqah. Today you see a banana, it's fell in the seed, can break some people, and you walk around and you leave it. Like we're not there. As you don't see any, you take hasanat, collected. You never know, this hasanat, day of judgment, can let you enter the Jannah. As the woman who just gives some water for the dog, or the woman she put the cat in the cage, Allah promised her the hellfire, wal'adhu billah. Be among the Jannah people. Be among the people who care about the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear brothers and sisters, I'm not taking a minute to say what's after Ramadan. Every single day for us is a meaning, because no one can guarantee his life. Qulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa lisa'il mu'minin. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, I keep bargaining with every one of us to open his heart inside his house. Treat the family the right way. Every single week I have to say that from the amount of trouble we are facing outside. And we not in the grade that we can fix anything. It's you. If you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will make it very easy for you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advised us by the ma'uzat, to recite the ma'uzat when you wake up. Before you sleep, you make dua. Be in wudu all the time. All of that can filter anything you think about it. Isn't the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, when you make the wudu, all the bad things drop from your hand, even though at the madmada, even though from your nose and your eyes, what you are looking for, where are you going? Let your body guide you by the heart and the brain, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks you to do it. Al-wajh wa ma wa'a. That's what the hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wal-batn wa ma hawa. The face and what's in it, it's your guidance. Eyes, where are you look all the time? Remember this hadith very well. The nose and what you smell, the ear and what you hear, the tongue what you are saying, and the batn at what you eat inside, halal or haram. Today, if you go to Costco, it's a big sign for the halal foods. You go to Jetro, big sign for the halal food. You know why? Because you and me, we refuse to eat any food. So they want to make money from you and me. So they put this sign. So your word is there. Your word to eat the halal is there. So let the people follow what we need. We don't follow what they need. ومن الناس من يتخذ من دون الله أندادا يحبونهم كحب الله. They choose other people to be a guidance. They love them as they love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala والعياذ بالله. So we need among the people who love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yes, we eat halal. And we ask the people who has halal stores, please decrease the price too. Because when you hear the brother say, brother, I go to the supermarket, the meat over there, the pound is $2.99, but my brother said to me for $6.99 because it's halal. Bismillah, Allahu Akbar, I eat and that's it. So that make all the big company like Jetro and Costco, they put the halal there and the price is good there too. So we have no excuse today to let this stomach eat the halal. We don't eat much. We eat and control ourselves because Rasulullah is telling us when you sit down and eat, third in your stomach, third for the water, third for your breath. But alhamdulillah, we eat until we cannot even breathe. We eat until here. But when we come to the donation for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we backed up. Tell me now, one masjid can survive in these days without any donation? They cannot. But us, we have to do it. We need to keep the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open. We need to put our hand there. We need to ask by ourselves about the electricity, how we can pay, the insurance, how we maintain the place. You don't need the leader or the shura member asking. We see that in the Facebook, everybody asking. And everybody hold his money. You're not taking anything with you. The virus teaching us something. Money now is not handling like before. The cards. Put the cards. Because sanitizing. Is not teaching us the money is nothing. Time will come, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when you give the money for the poor, say, no, I don't need it, I have. Money will never help. And when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbi rij'un, let me go back. Atasaddaq, I will give sadaqah. It's too late. Time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will write it. This is the time for you to leave the dunya. Take with you the good deeds. Ignore all the bad deeds. Be together with your family. Be with your friend. Be among the people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْ رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا. Together, inshallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow all of us to be among there and to be with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi jannatin na'im. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa kaffir anna sayyatina. Allahumma ashfi maradana marada al-muslimin wa rahma amwatana amwat al-muslimin. Allahumma la taj'al lana dhanban illa ghafartah wa la maridan illa shafaytah wa la mayitan illa rahimtah. Allahumma inna salaka rudaka wal jannah wa na'udhu bika min sakhatika wal nar. Allahumma taqabbal a'malana fi ramadan. Allahumma aj'al hajj muyassran lana ya akram al-akramin. Allahumma aj'alna min allazina yusalluna fi baytika al-haram. اللهم اجمعنا في جماعا يا رب العالمين في بيت رسول الله اللهم أرنا مناسك الحج يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم أرنا مناسك الحج يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم لا تحرمنا الحج يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم لا تحرمنا الحج يا أكرم الأكرمين يا ربنا إنه يوم في العام فلا تحرمنا وقفة عرفات اللهم اجعلنا ممن يقفون على عرفات اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يقفون على عرفات
اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يصلون في بيتك المقدس اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يذهبون إلى القدس سالمين غانمين مصلين أكم الأكرمين اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين اللهم أعينهم على الحق اللهم ثبت أقدامهم اللهم تقبل شهداءهم اللهم اطعمهم من طعام أهل الجنة يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم اكسي أبناءهم وارحم أزواجهم يا أكرم الأكرمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين عباد الله رحمني ورحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم وأقم الصلاة